this is Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And today we're going to go over how to avoid an index error when you want to cycle back to the beginning of a list. So let's start by creating our list. And let's pretend that it's some sort of grid where we have a player involved in the grid. So I'm just going to make the grid a simple 1D array. So let's go ahead and make grid a set of spaces that I'll represent with underscores. And we'll make this a size of 5. So when I print out this grid, you can see that I have 5 spaces, indicating that those are open for the player to move across. Now, if we have a grid, we also need a player. So let's create our player. And let's make the player the at symbol. So if I want to place the player at the start of our list, or the start of that world on the very far left-hand side, we're going to say that the grid of that index 0 is equal to player. And there we have it. You can see that my player is here. Now I want them to move, but I want this to be a cyclic world or a cyclic list. So I want them to move, and when they get to the end of the list, I want them to automatically go back to the beginning. Well, how do we do this? Let's do it with a for loop. Let's say that our player is going to move forward, but I don't want them to go to the end of the list yet. So let's just say for I in range 3, we're going to set the grid of I to be where the player is at. Now think about this. If I print out the grid, now I'm going to have 3 players populated on this board. Because as my player's moving, I'm not taking into account that previous space now that the player's not in. So I'm just going to fix that. In my for loop, I'm going to add the grid of I minus 1 is going to be set back to that original underscore string. And just so we can see the player movement, let's go ahead and move this print statement inside of our for loop. And there we go. So when we're at 0, grid of 0, we're assigning that player to that space, I minus 1, so 0 minus 1 is grid negative 1. We're making sure that last element in the list is that underscore. Then our player moves to grid I of 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0. This now changes back to its original value of the underscore, and so on. But let's try this now. If I want my player to move, let's say 10 places forward, or 10 times. So it should cycle back to the beginning and keep going. Printing out I, we can see that we're going to get an error, because once we get to the end of the list, when I is equal to 5, there is no index of 5. The max index is an index of 4, because we start at 0, then go to 1, 2, 3, 4. So my max index is 4, thus when I go to 5, I get an error. But there's a simple fix, and that's with the modulo. If we mod I with the length of our world, the length of our list, our grid, that means when I gets to that value of 5, if our grid world is size 5, 5 divided by 5 gives me a remainder of 0, so we're going to go back to the beginning of the list. Then when we're at an I value of 6, 5 goes evenly into that once with a remainder of 1, so then we're going to be at index 1, and so on. So let's also use the modulo for I minus 1, and I'm going to print out I, and I also want to see how that I value changes, just to show you how it works. So now when we run this, no more error, and look, I starts out at 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and when it gets to 5, it goes back to index 0. At 6, the modulo will give us a value of 1. When it's 7, 5 goes into 7 evenly one time with a remainder of 2, so then we'll be in index 2, and so on. And that's how you go back to the beginning of the list, avoiding those index errors. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button. And comment below how else you think this tip would be useful when programming. But as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. Happy learning!